I read from John chapter 1, verses 35 through the first part of verse 42. Again the next day, John was standing with two of his disciples, and he looked at Jesus as he walked and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard him speak, and they followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which is to say, being interpreted, "teacher, where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and see." They came and saw where he was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about the 10th hour. One of the two who heard John and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He first found his own brother, Simon, and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which is being interpreted, Christ. He brought him to Jesus. Jesus had every base covered, it seems, when he invited his 12 disciples. By that, I mean we all can connect with at least one of them. And if not one of the 12, then one of the wider group of women and men who followed him. Here we have one that I would consider every person's disciple, or the common man. His identity is really captured in the phrase from our passage, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. That really describes Andrew for us. The gospel writers never refer to Simon Peter, or just Peter, as Andrew's brother. Peter was far too assertive, explosive, and impulsive to be identified by reference to another. But Andrew is a different story. Peter would get all of the attention in a gathering. Then someone would point to Andrew and ask, "Who is he?" "Oh, he's the brother." Andrew never seemed to mind. In the Gospels, he is always identified in reference to another person, and he always brings that other person to Jesus. He did so with Peter. Andrew was a seeker. First, he attached himself to John the Baptizer. John was preaching a message of holiness and renewal. Andrew responded and was baptized by John in the Jordan River. One day John was preaching and saw afar off someone coming, "Behold the Lamb of God." Andrew followed John's gaze and saw Jesus for the first time. Andrew was there when Jesus was baptized by John, when the Spirit of God settled on Jesus, and when Jesus came out of the wilderness after 40 days of temptation. John the Baptizer had taken Andrew as far as he could, and now this seeker followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following and said to them, "What are you looking for?" And Andrew stayed. Maybe the translation does not give us the full picture. Let me use my imagination. "Jesus, what do you seek?" "Andrew, teacher, I want to see how you live." "Jesus, then come and see." Andrew is the first disciple who is invited to follow. It is a big decision to be the first. If you're second, then at least you have some point of comparison, a context. But the first person must have trust and commitment. Andrew was an ordinary person with extraordinary faith. Do you remember the gospel story of Jesus feeding of the 5,000? Jesus asks his followers how they could feed that many. The 12 are overwhelmed with the task and begin to calculate the cost. Andrew is the only one present who gives a possible solution, a solution that would appear to fall far short, but at least give it a try, Andrew brings a small boy who has 5 loaves and 2 fish to Jesus. Everyone is fed with that. Then there was the time when some Greeks came to Philip seeking an introduction to Jesus. Where did Philip turn? Philip took the Greeks to Andrew, who took them to Jesus. Andrew was always bringing others to Jesus. Andrew is never listed alone among the disciples. The stories about him always find him with someone else, another disciple usually. That is why I think of him as the average person. His name suggests as much. Andrew is the English form of a very common name in many languages. In Greek, the name is Andreas, and its root word is Andros, which simply means man. Andrew's name in Hebrew was probably Adam. He was a person, an average man who introduced others to Jesus and who sparked the miracle of the feeding of the 5,000. He was not a great leader in the church, as we look in the book of Acts, but he did bring Peter to Jesus. In the Greek, Andrew means more than man. It means brave, strong, courageous, and warrior. Even we average folks can be that too. I sort of like this Andrew. Maybe he would be a good model for my life following Jesus. Tradition tells us that Andrew took the gospel to Russia, Georgia, in the former Soviet Union, Cyprus, Romania, and the Ukraine. Legend also has that Scotland adopted Andrew as its patron saint because he invented golf. Well, I'm just kidding about that. Andrew is the patron saint of Scotland because allegedly his relics were miraculously brought there. The flag of Scotland is a white cross in the shape of an X, Andrew's cross, on a field of azure blue. Tradition also holds that Andrew was crucified on such a cross in Greece on November 30th, AD 60. What a life for the first follower of Jesus. He introduced Peter to Jesus, and Peter, with Paul, established Christianity in Western Europe. Andrew traveled throughout Eastern Europe. Together, both brothers covered an entire continent. He sparked a miracle with the feeding of the 5,000. He invented golf. Sorry, I did that again. An average man, do you think? Well, maybe to start. But when he responded to Jesus' invitation to follow, all that changed. And so it does for us. By God's grace and for His purpose, we are no longer ordinary. But by faith, we are extraordinary.
Sometimes I have
Welcome to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/c/johnslider. You are encouraged to join us and subscribe to this channel. We currently have over 2,900 subscribers, and the number is growing as we speak. The channel is approaching 1.5 million lifetime views and averaging over 11,000 weekly views. There are more than 3,000 videos available. One of the features of our library of videos are readings from the Old Testament and New Testament, chapter by chapter. We add to this library regularly. Another feature of this channel are the collections of music, traditional Christian music, contemporary Christian music, and inspirational music. A recent addition to the channel are original audiobooks. Currently, the library has chapter-by-chapter readings of A Soldier of the King and A Servant of the Lord. The channel has many other offerings that you may explore through the playlist. All of the resources on the channel are free to you. The channel is a ministry and not for profit. We neither solicit nor accept any funding from you or any other source.